Silence, so stay in place. Thank you. Be seated, please.
Jury had a very long day. I propose to get them in and ask them if they would prefer to continue their deliberations tonight and in the morning. Bring the jury.
Both Ryan and Walker, either expressly or implicitly,
that they would together commit a felony of violence, namely escaping from jail. And if in the course of committing such felony, some sort of prevention from carrying their purpose into effect would be dealt with by violent means, at least to the extent of inflicting grievous bodily harm, then Walker would be guilty of murder. If you were satisfied, beyond reasonable doubt, that it was understood between the accused, that is, between both Ryan and Walker, both being a party to it either expressly or implicitly, that they would together commit a felony of violence, namely escaping from jail, and in the course of committing such felony, some sort of prevent them from carrying their purpose into effect would be dealt with by violent means, at least to the extent of inflicting grievous bodily harm, that Walker would be guilty of murder. Now, to satisfy this admission, the Crown must prove beyond reasonable doubt these things. Firstly, that Ryan killed Hudson, and that he was guilty of murder, has been fine for him. Secondly, there was a felony. There was a prearrangement to commit a felony of violence, namely, escaping from jail. Thirdly, that the killing was in the course of committing such felony, or in the furtherance of its purpose and before it was completed. In other words, the felony must still be in the course of the commission at the time of the agreement. Next, that the prearrangement included an agreement to use such violence as was necessary, at least to the extent of inflicting grievous bodily harm. This means that it must be proved, beyond reasonable doubt, that Walker was party to a prearrangement under which he must have contemplated, or as a reasonable man should have contemplated, that the violence to be used, if necessary, by Ryan and himself was likely to result in death or grievous bodily harm. That is, in serious bodily harm. Next week, the Crown must prove that the Consul, that is, the common purpose, persisted until the time of the shooting. And finally, they must establish beyond reasonable doubt that the violence used was not beyond the scope of the prearrangement. If you are satisfied of those things beyond reasonable doubt, it is open to you to find Walker guilty of murder. If, however, you are satisfied that all the above elements existed, except you are not satisfied, beyond reasonable doubt, that the prearrangement to which Walker was a party, if any, was one under which he must have contemplated, or as a reasonable man should have contemplated, that the violence he used was likely to result in death or grievous bodily harm, or you are satisfied beyond reasonable doubt that Walker was party to a prearrangement under which some lesser violence was to be used, not calculated to cause death or bodily injury, but to cause a lesser injury. Then it is open to you to find Walker guilty of manslaughter. Is there anything else, Mr. Foreman?
I think that covers it.
Very well. Will you continue your deliberations, please? I leave for that.
Silence, all stand by.
Thank you.
Thank you. Be seated, please.
Gentlemen, I believe we have a verdict in the jury. Take the jury's verdict, please.
Gentlemen of the jury, have you agreed upon your verdict?
We have.
Do you find the accused Ryan guilty or not guilty of murder?
Guilty of murder.
Do you find the accused Walker guilty or not guilty of murder?
Not guilty of murder, guilty of manslaughter.
Do you find the prisoner Ryan guilty of murder, and is that the verdict of you all?
Yes.
Do you find the prisoner Walker not guilty of murder, but guilty of manslaughter, and is that the verdict of you all?
Yes.
Gentlemen of the jury, I must ask you to go to your room for a moment or two. I won't be very long, gentlemen. Remove the accused Walker. I want him kept outside the court, near the precincts.
Prisoner at the bar, Ryan, you have been found guilty of murder. Have you anything to say, or do you know why the sentence of death should not be passed upon you according to law?
I still maintain my innocence. I will rely on my counsel to appeal. That is all I have to say.
Long Joseph Ryan, you have been found guilty of the murder of George Henry Hudson. It is the sentence of this court that you be taken from here to the place from whence you came, and on a day and an hour to be fixed by the Executive Council, you shall be hanged by the neck until you are dead.